Okay, so we've spoken a ton about Patrick Laine and his whole situation with the Winnipeg Jets, whether or not he is actually going to get traded or moved or something, but we're kind of bringing up a little bit of a different perspective here in this video. We're not talking only about the trade rumors and the trade proposals and the hearsay around North America, but we're actually taking a look at a perspective from across the pond. Because what happened earlier this week on Reddit was an article was posted over onto the site. It was posted onto Our Hockey by a user named The Finnish Champ, and the article is actually in Finnish. It's on a Finnish website called, oh man, iltalehi.fi, and if you translate the title from Finnish into English, the title says, Why Patrick Laine Will Leave the Jets. So, before we go over what exactly is said here in this article, let's just build on the context a little bit. Patrick Laine, 2016 second overall pick, he was a number one projected goal scorer ever since the draft, and in his years in the NHL, he has potted up quite a few goals. However, as a guy who is indeed on a bridge deal, and as a guy who doesn't really have the most positive morale with the team according to all the speculation we have seen over the past few weeks, Laine is a guy who has been out there on the trade rumor side of things when it comes to North American media, and according to some counts, apparently the Winnipeg Jets would really be interested in the idea if it means they can get a second line center back or a defender too, because hey, they need both of those things. So, what exactly is said over here on this article in Finnish? Let's go over onto Reddit first and take a look at the Finnish Champ's own little description, because that is in English, so it's very translatable and easy to read. This is a very interesting piece, and the journalist who is over here written on the article, it is Pekka Jalonen. This journalist has done several interviews with Laine, so he knows what Laine thinks better than most. Basically, Patrick Laine's camp is trying to get to arbitration, and then get around a $9 million deal until spring 2023, after which he will leave unless he gets a deal worth over $10 million. And that's not possible with the Jets' forward salaries at the salary cap. Okay, first off, before we proceed, what is that? That is quite prominent of an idea over here. Let's go over onto the actual article and read where it talks about that specific idea. We're translating this through the Google machine and going over what exactly is said. It's mentioned in the paragraph how this is indeed what arbitration would look like for Patrick Laine, and then if they wanted to keep him as well later on in 2023, they would need to sign him to over $10 million a season, which Cheveldayev cannot make without a magic trick, according to the source over here. The article cites different pieces on the Jets already talking about the expensive contracts already on the team, and how this would prevent the Jets from actually being able to make a signing that Laine would actually take the pen and put over to the dotted line. So, what happens after that? It's why the Jets are trying to get offers for him. Patrick Laine is also frustrated because of not playing with a great center and other things, so he is happy to go somewhere else. We also have an apparent timeline, because the journalist says that Cheveldayev will have to do the trade before next season, but it won't happen before the draft. So, staying over with Reddit and discussing what's actually talked about here in the comments section, they talk a little bit about playing with Scheifele and how Laine wants to do that more, and then we have ourselves a little explanation of the actual situation. As mentioned by the Finnish Champ, he says this, that Laine played the previous season with Brian Little, and that obviously left some bad feelings. Also the fact that Little getting a big deal prevented the Jets from giving Stastny a deal, who was really the guy that Patrick Laine excelled with back when he was in the Winnipeg Jets organization. That indeed is also mentioned in the article. But the big way that this article is actually wrapped up is quite telling of apparently the story at hand here. The article ends with, when the news of Laine trade is announced, the happiest man will be Laine himself. Now that's kind of poetic. I get that it's translated from Finnish into English, and thus the grammar isn't really the best, but despite that last sentence being so beautifully written, it kind of gives off a very intriguing message to this entire Line A story, where the context, the team, the contract, the line mates, all that stuff has piled together into this snowball that ultimately could lead to Patrick Line A's eventual departure from Winnipeg, either via a trade this offseason or once his UFA post-arbitration contract negotiation comes in 2023. So unless Kevin Cheveldayoff is able to make some trades, free up some money to give Patrick Laine as soon as his next contract extension is due, from all these factors, it doesn't really look like we have a timeline that sees Patrick Laine continue his career into the long-term future as a member of the Winnipeg Jets. So that's kind of the entire idea why the article is titled Why Patrick Laine Will Leave the Jets, and not specifically why he will get traded, because the implication is even if he doesn't get traded, an inevitable departure will indeed occur. So now we transition over into North American journalism as we take a look at what Bruce Garriott said earlier on the Ottawa Sun. Take a look at this. This is his most recent article talking about the Tampa Bay Lightning and how reality is setting in for them after their cup win. It was uploaded yesterday. Let's take a little bit of a scroll down into the around the board section of this article, where the first sentence kind of tells the entire story we're talking about here. An interesting team to watch on the Patrick Laine front may be the Flyers. And the talk is, they're making an aggressive push. They have the ability to make the deal if they can find the right fit with the Jets. A league executive speculated Sunday, the Flyers would probably want to see if there's a fit in Winnipeg for Shane Gostisbehere. Now, we've spoken about Gostisbehere before. We spoke about the Johnny Gaudreau trade rumors that have been going on that involve Gostisbehere's name as well. Check that video out if you haven't seen it. But skipping over into the middle of the paragraph, it also talks about how the Winnipeg Jets need a second line center, which is indeed what we have talked about a ton on this channel before as well. And then it talks about how apparently the Jackets and the Canadiens are both believed to have made pitches for Patrick Laine. So, that's different. We spoke a few days ago about how apparently Marc Bergevin was not really intending on going after Patrick Laine because the price would be too high. We saw that report come out with several other people talking about it too, that Laine, Hall, they're off the table because the price would be too much. But now, according to Garriott, there's a belief that the Habs might have already made an offer, along with the same Blue Jackets team we have spoken about a ton in the past. But then you take a look at what exactly the Jets could get in return. Philippe Deneau is a name that's put out there, so that indeed is something to consider. If it's Deneau, then hey man, he wanted second line minutes. He's going to get second line minutes playing alongside of, I don't know, Kyle Connor. Like, that's really good. Imagine having a Winnipeg Jets team with Deneau. That would be incredible. The paragraph then continues, talks about a few other options, a few other teams that might have interest, a few other free agents that the Jets might be able to go after if they so pleased. But I think as this is going on, now that it's already the draft is going to happen a few hours after this video is uploaded. We're going to stream for that, by the way, so if you want draft coverage, check out the YouTube channel once the draft actually goes on. But as this is coming closer, and as we are in a position where more teams are going to start to kind of panic a little bit, I guess, because we have ourselves the UFA period opening up in a few days, and this is kind of where crunch time will start. It's where we'll see the big offers coming in for the UFAs from teams who have the money to spend it, and we'll see a lot of preliminary moves done from teams who are looking to open themselves up to that possibility, and maybe even on the flip side, use that free time to extend their own window of opportunity to sign the guys that they already have under their system. So we'll see for sure if this whole Laine thing actually goes down the way Mr. Writer over here in the Finnish article portrays it to. That a trade before the draft might not happen, but between now and the start of 2020-2021, we might have ourselves a Laine deal then, is yet to be seen. And of course, if you want to take a time machine, go all the way to 2023 and let me know if his assessment in Patrick Laine not getting a $10 million contract because of other guys they already have in their organization, and as a result, him leaving the Jets is accurate, then feel free to do so. But I don't think anybody has a time machine over there, so we're just gonna have to wait 3 years ourselves to see if that actually does happen. But if it does, then that'd be very weird to talk about. I'd be very interested in seeing Patrick Laine in a different jersey just for the heck of it. But if it's Montreal, if it's Columbus, if it's Philadelphia, like any of these teams Bruce Garriott is mentioning could have already made offers, then we'll see exactly how that goes down. Marc Bergevin is in a different position, in my opinion, because he already said before that they didn't want to do it, so I don't know why he's in this conversation now. The Blue Jackets were in that original conversation too, but it was noted that they really wanted the goal scorer. And as for the Flyers, hey, we talked about them and Gaudreau. Talking about them with Laine doesn't really change the dynamic all too much, in my opinion. So comment down below what you think about this whole video topic over here, Laine's inevitable departure from Winnipeg via trade or free agency, and the teams that could have been involved. So, talk to me in the comments if you enjoyed this video. That's Trollus 99, and bye.